अस्सलाम वालेकुम, वेलकम बैक टू यूनिवर्सल ऑटोमेशन। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस हाउ टू कम्युनिकेट HMI एंड VFD थ्रू मोडबस प्रोटोकॉल। आई विल यूज बेजर 7 इंच HMI एंड मित्सुबिशी VFD। यू कैन सी मोडबस RS-485 कनेक्शन डायग्राम बिटवीन HMI एंड VFD ऑन स्क्रीन। बेसिकली RS-485 प्रोटोकॉल हैव टू टाइप्स ऑफ वायरिंग कनेक्शन, which is 4 wire and 2 wire connections. I will use 2 wire connection for HMI and VFD. As you see, I will use HMI COM port 2 for Modbus communication. Let's start with practical connections between VFD and HMI. As you see on screen, I will connect RS-485 wire to the HMI Modbus port. Now I will connect Ethernet cable with my computer, and for the power of HMI I will connect power connector to the HMI 24 volt DC. Now we will install RS-485 parameters on VFD. There is 6 basic parameters for RS-485 communication, which is parameter number 331, that is station number. Basically our HMI is master and VFD is slave, so that our HMI station number is 0 and VFD station number is 1. Parameter number 332, which is communication speed between HMI and VFD, I will set 192 in the parameter. The next parameter is 333, which is data length. We will set it to 0. The next parameter is communication check time. That is parameter number 539. If the communication between HMI and VFD is not good and time exceed from the set point, then alarm occurred in HMI, that is communication error. We will set in parameter 539 0 second. The next and most important parameter is 549, which is protocol selection. We will set RTU protocol in parameter number 549. Now let's create a HMI project. IS developer 2.40 is used to develop HMI projects. I will create a new project. Our HMI is X2 base 7 inch. The model I select. We will press the next button. And now we will select the controller. That is Modicon. Modicon is a company that is provide Modbus protocols. As you see on the screen, I will select my HMI on a master mode and my VFD is a slave station. Now we all set. We will give him a name, which is a Modbus demo. I will create 3 integer values for displaying VFD hertz, VFD volts and VFD amperes. There is a lot of more parameters to display on the screen, but we will basically display just 3 parameters. Now we will save the project and now we will go to the controller communication settings. As you see, our Modbus protocol is RTU, default station is 0, that is master. We will set Modbus address into 1 base because of HMI is master and VFD is slave, and its station number start from 1. There are 2 types of COM ports in HMI. COM port 1 is ported RS232 communication. That's why I will set my HMI COM port into 2, which is ported RS485 communication. I will set my communication speed into 192. All the communication parameters as same as VFD parameters. Now we will set all the communication parameters. Now let's create Modbus addresses in TXT. The Modbus addressing of VFD is given to VFD instruction manual. I will give you a link of Mitsubishi VFD of RA800 instruction manual in the description. You can easily download from there. As you see, I will link my integer values to the Modbus addresses that is created in tag session. We will set every integer into decimal point so that we will get the value in points. All done. Now we will download the project into HMI. The downloading process is complete. Now let's check the communication between VFD and HMI. As you can see, I run my VFD. VFD hertz is displaying on a screen as well as on VFD. The VFD frequency is accelerating to the maximum frequency, which is 50 hertz. We press set button on VFD. The VFD is displaying amperes on screen. and if we press again set button, the VFD is displaying output voltage of VFD. As you see, you will read VFD parameters into screen through 485 protocol, and also you will set VFD parameters through HMI using 485 Modbus protocol. Thank you for watching today's video. If you liked my tutorial, please subscribe to Universal Automation for more interesting videos. Allah Hafiz.